Hello everyone, in this video I am going to show you how can you calculate the beta value by four different methods. First of all, log in into the Google Chrome and just open the Yahoo Finance. Here I am going to download the historical data of Nifty Index, which is my market determinant in this calculation. Go to the historical data tab and just set a limit of 6 months, apply and download. And now I'm going to download a historical data of any component of Nifty Index. So go to the component tab. Here is the list of all the companies which are listed in National Stock Exchange and indexed as a Nifty Index. Now here I am going to take a data of Hito Motor Corp. You can take a data of any other company. Now I'm going to select the historical data and apply the same time period criteria, apply and download. Now I'm going to open both the sheet, and here's the date. First of all, I'm going to copy all the date in a separate sheet. As we all know that to calculate the beta value, we only require the adjusted close value. So I am going to copy the adjusted close value for both Hero Motor Corp index and Nifty index. At the same sheet. Here I am going to rename this column as adjusted close value of Hero. Now I'm going to copy the adjusted close value of Nifty for the same time period. And I'm going to rename this column as adjusted close value of Nifty. Now I'm going to calculate here the return. First of all, name the column return of Hero. Or another column as return of Nifty. It's a simple method to calculate the return. Just put is equal to take P2 divided by P3 minus 1. Take enter. Here is my return. Between the dates 17 and 18, and now I am going to apply this function to entire date to calculate the return for Nifty and Hero for 6 month for which the data I have taken. But this formula cannot apply at the last value, because after the 14th 8 2020 there is no data, so we cannot calculate the return for 14-8-2020. So now I'm going to calculate the beta value by four different methods. First is slope method. Just click into a cell and type is equal to and click SLOPE, and here is the slope function. Double click on the slope function to select, and now I am going to select the Hero Motor Corp return first. And insert comma, and now I'm going to select the Nifty return again. And close the bracket and press enter. That provide me a beta value. My beta value is 0.87192. Now I'm going to calculate the beta value with variance covariance method. Just insert is equal to and type covariance of P. Now here I am going to select the Hero Motor Corp return as RF1 and just put the comma and select Nifty return as RF2. close the bracket and divided this function with a variance of p function, variance of p function of determinant return, that is nifty return. Now I'm going to select the nifty return to calculate the variance of nifty and divide the covariance function with the variance function of nifty and just close the formula and click enter. That provide me a beta value, and I'm going to calculate the beta value with the regression method. Just go to the data tab and go to the left upper side of the Excel. Here is the data analysis tool pack, and scroll down all the way to the regression. Here is the regression. Click regression and select regression and OK. And insert the X range. Insert the hero motor pop return as a X range. And insert nifty return as a Y range. And just click the residual value. And just here, click OK. That provide me a beta value. Here is my beta value. Here in this column, at the last, X variable is equal to 0.8719. And as you see, the value is same, 0.8719. And the value I have calculated here with the slope method or variance flow method, that is 0.8719, 0.8719. Now I'm going to calculate the beta value with scatter diagram with the last method, last and fourth method. Now here I'm going to add data. Select data. And now I am going to name the series as beta and X value as my nifty return. And Y value as my hero motor pop return. I'm going to click OK. Provide me a scatter diagram chart. Now I'm going to insert a trend line in this chart and click these two options, display the equation on chart and display the R square value. And here is my beta value. As you see, Y is equal to 0.8719. Here is my beta value. There is a fourth method to calculate the beta value. All these methods are very different, but the answer of the beta calculation always be same. Here is you select the different design, and I think this design would be very presentable at any platform. Thank you very much.